Packages in Java is a mechanism to encapsulate a group of classes, sub-packages and interfaces. So how would you understand a package? So for example, import java.util.star and import java.util.scanner. So what is the meaning of these two lines? So if you just look over the diagram I have drawn over here, think the outer package as Java and the inner packages we have lang, util, io, net and awt, and inside util there is a scanner class. So what we are using, that the Java, inside the Java major folder, this is a Java major folder, inside that we have a util class, we have a util folder. So inside the util folder we have scanner class. So this is how in java.util.scanner is explained. Use of Java packages. So the first use of Java package is to preventing naming conflicts. For example, there can be two classes with the employee in two packages, with the employee in two packages, called college.staff.cac.employee and college.staff.ee.employee. So here we have seen that there are two classes with the same name, but they are in different packages. So this is how it is being split up. So look in the diagram. The college is the main folder. Inside that we have another folder called staff, and inside the staff folder we have two folders. One is CAC and another one is EE. So and inside CAC we have employee.java and inside EE we have employee.java. So this is how we are differentiating the two classes with the same name but in different packages. Making search and usage of classes, interfaces, enumeration and annotation easier, since they are in a way that the search, then the annotations and the interfaces and enumerations are there. So we can search in as a whole to clearly find out where the contents of a file is there. Next one is providing access control. So in Java we have three access modifiers: public, static, public, private and protected. So public, in public we have private, protected. And so what is public? So we can access the class from outside the package, inside the package, different class and same class. Inside private we can access outside package, inside we cannot access the outside the package, inside the package, different class or the same class. And protected means that outside the package we cannot access, but we can access the class inside the package, different class or same class. Now, then the last thing is that packages can be considered as a data encapsulation or data hiding. Now, what are the different types of packages? So there are six built-in packages: java.lang, java.io, java.util, java.applet, java.awt and java.net. So the full form of java.awt is that abstract window toolkit. So the full form of Java util is that awt is that abstract window toolkit. So we will, and there is another called user defined packages, where we will define our own classes, our own functions, our own packages to make sure that we can use in other programs. So what is the use of java.lang? So whatever data types, primitive data types, functions are falls under the java.lang. So java.lang means that Java language. Any program you write in Java is always being imported into java.lang. Why? Because java.lang is the default package of any Java program, whether you use a Java package, java.lang package or not. Okay, so println, print, then system package, that the way we have written system.out.println, this is also falls under java.lang. java.lang is a mother package of all classes. For example, mat.pow, mat.cl, this kind of packages are also present inside it. java.io. java.io means input output. Import java.io.star, we will later deal with it when we will be using buffer reader to accept the data. Java util contains utility classes which implements data structure, linked list, dictionary, etc. and date time operation as well. The most famous one is the scanner class, which we will use to accept many data types. So java.util contains the scanner class, which is the most important one when we will accepting those values. So how would you define? So you will write import java.util.start to accept the values. Next one is java.applet. Contains classes for creating applet. Applets are a small programs which runs on the browser. Then java.awt. Java.awt, I have already told, abstract window toolkit. Contains the classes for implementing the components for graphical user interface like buttons, menus, etc. So for example, the button, the slider, the panel, whatever the graphical user interface are there, we always use the Java abstract window toolkit to implement those things. Now streams is an abstraction that either brings or sends data. Java program performs input output through streams, reading and writing. Reading means opens a stream. So what happens during reading a file? So first step is that it opens a stream, then while reading more information, it will continue to read information until and unless there is no information left to read. Then it reads the information each one by one, character one, and then what happens is that if all the information are empty, then it will close out. Then writing. So writing is similar to reading. So first of all, we need to open a stream. Then while the more information is there, it will continue to iterate till there is no information to write in its path. Then it will write the information. Then when the information inside the program is exhausted, then the stream will be closed out. Character streams. So character streams is one of the streams inside the Java streams Java streams class. So the character streams has two things: reader and writer. So for example, java.io.str is a character stream. So character stream accepts 16-bit characters. Reader streams that read 16-bit characters, and writer streams that which write 16-bit characters as well. Now byte streams. Byte streams has input streams and output streams, which is a 8-bit character. So input stream and output stream we will deal with when we will be writing the programs with input stream reader and your input stream writer. Now scanner class. Now scanner class is one of the important things in our syllabus, because we will be writing maximum programs to input to accept the values with these methods. So first method is next short. Next short to accept short data type values. Short b equals sc.next short. So it can accept values ranging from -32,640 to plus 32,647. Next int to accept integer data type values. Int a equals sc.next int to accept the integer related values. Next long to accept long integer data type values. Long c equal to sc.next long to accept long values. Next float to accept the floating data type. It is written as sc.next float. So what you are thinking that, okay, sc.next float, how would you accept that? Okay, so sc.next float is basically when you write the scanner classes scanner sc equal to new scanner system.in, we write that float as d equal to sc.next float. So what is this sc? So basically this one is the object. So if you write, for example, if you write in place of sc, in some books they are written in format, so this will become in dot next float. So if you write your name also, suppose Rahul, scanner Rahul equal to new scanner system dot in float d equal to, it will become what? Rahul dot next float. So this is how we will accept declare the scanner class and accept those values. So this sc is the basically an object name. Now next double to accept the double data type values, double z equals to sc dot next double. So we will do up to here. In the next video we'll talk about the next one, the next class, next method, and the next line method.